that Brahmin considered himself to take his food outside, not in the kitchen. Why I put this is, in earlier days, every household, whether it is a Brahmin or any other household, they used to have their food inside the house, restricted to the kitchen. They had to sit down, square themselves down, and they used to have the food there. Just compare your house now. You will be sitting in the sofa and watching the TV and you will be having your food. Where? In your drawing room. It is not at all a place to take food, even now, for the hygienic conditions. Whatever the hygienic conditions you have in your kitchen and in your dining hall or your dining table, the very same hygienic condition won't prevail in your lounge or in your bedroom or in your drawing room. Even then, we prefer to take our food in the bedroom or in the hall, sitting in the sofa watching the TV. See the difference. People used to pray before taking any food. Now, here and here I will see, nobody is watching, no. Simply I will say this and I eat. Nothing I do, I want to put it in public. But I want to take the food in public. Earlier, everything restricted to house. Take your food in the house. So if at all that person, though belong to the same family, if at all he is asked to go out, your plate is outside, you eat your food there, it is just like a punishment to the boy or to the man. You are a member of that family and you have been asked to take your food outside the kitchen. It is just like a punishment. The same she felt. Okay, you come. You can eat in my kitchen, but I won't serve. That was the condition for the first time. And all along our Kalamsa was telling, no sir, I will go home and I will have my food over there. Don't bother. You take your food. All along he was telling. But that orthodox Brahmin, he was very firm and he took the boy inside his kitchen. He served him there. What is the greatness in it then? The thing which follows next is the great thing. Once again, after several days, Abdul Kalam was invited by the same science teacher for a food. Remembering the past experience, he said, no sir, maaf kijiye mujhe. Main ghar jaake khana khata hu. No. You are eating food. And that missus of the teacher, she invited. You see, if you don't take food through my hands, in my kitchen, I feel I am insulted. You come inside. That kind of tolerance was there, what I mean to say. When pre-independent days, World War II means what? Maybe 43 or maybe 45 or 46 in those days. This was the tolerance between two religions. Now where we are, just compare. So this tolerance was there, is there, will be there for years in Indians. That is what our Abdul Kalam has put through his my childhood days. That is the biggest lesson he taught. We were like this. We were never faced any kind of difficulty to be there in the society. Never we bothered. Never. And due respect they used to get. Whatever the respect they had to get, they used to get that kind of respect. Now it is something different. And so we have to go back and read all these things. So that is what you are going to read in your this one. And spirit of unity once again. Spirit of unity. We help each other. Help each other means what? In whatever this condition may be. There we rush. We can see somewhere in Uttarakhand something had happened. And the relief measures will go from here. Somewhere in Himachal Pradesh something happens, relief goes from here. Somewhere in Maharashtra, relief measures will go from here. That is your unity. We have that spirit, unity of spirit within ourselves. If there is a terrorist attack, if there is a what we call as a derailment, people go and they help the other people to come. Today I was reading about some newspaper. There is some article is there. Some women, they have started some charity. Charity to what extent? There is no question of extent. What kind of help you need, you let us know it. That will be given. Small, when it is started, it is only a simple birthday celebration. That has been celebrated in some home for leper people. From there it started. They ate and they spent some time with them. They have given some help to them. Then again from there reciprocative. Nobody so far had come and they spent time with us. We have been looked at as we are unwanted. By that soft speaking itself, this woman was inspired. To many organizations, whatever the help can be done, it is being given. Now this charity and giving help to many people, it has started now everywhere. The other day I was looking at a video clipping which has come to my phone. He is requesting, you please send money to us. Don't throw it out. Don't burn it out. Don't tear it out. We are hearing people are just throwing the money into the rivers, throwing the money into the canals, etc. Don't throw. These are outdated denomination notes only. But we can make use of it. That way they had money. Charity is increased within ourselves. Why charity? Because it is the thing is we feel that we are all one. That is called your unity spirit. And next, mile sir mera tumara. This is a very famous song which was telecasted in the television during 1980s and 1990s. A very beautiful song wherein almost every Indian recognized language is there. About 16 languages the song goes. And almost every famous singer has put his voice here into it. You name Balamurali Krishna. Recently, this Tuesday, he expired. Right? He made this song, a unique song. Bhimsen Joshi of Maharashtra. Right? And even your Chaurasia, the flute masters and violin masters, sitar masters, mridangam masters, these are masters really. They have created this song in 16 languages they sung and they composed it and they have put the notes to it, lyrics to it and everything. Why? Because that is called Indianness. We have that spirit within us. How the song goes, you can see here. Mile Sir Mera Tumhara, as it is better known, is an Indian song and accompanying video feature promoting national integration and unity in diversity. Diversity because it is from Kerala, it is from Karnataka, it is from your Tamil Nadu, it is from Goa, it is from Odisha, it is from Punjab, it is from Gujarat, it is from Maharashtra, it is from Andhra. In from many places, one line or the other, it has come and it has been put over there in the same tune, in the same composition it has been put. Words are different, language is different, but the tune is same. And so, Mile Mera, Sur Mera Tumara. Sur means the composition, the song, the voice, the tune, the tone. Right? The concept of Milesur was developed in 1988 by Lok Seva Sanchar Parishad and promoted by Doordarshan of India, India Ministry of Information. The song was composed by Ashok Patki, co-composed and arranged by Louis Banks, written by Piyush Pandey, then the accounts manager and presently the executive chairman and the creative head of Ogilvy and Mather India. Then All India Radio creative director Ogilvy and Mather, and recorded by a group of people from all walks of life, including the super group of popular Indian musicians, sports personalities, movie stars, etc. We can see many movie stars over there. And Lata Mangeshkar, Asha Bhosle, and even your Sabna Azmi, and many people were there in that. Why? People of many different walks, they have come and they contributed to it. Why? They are to show we are one. We are one, they have to show it. So, the national integration video was intended to instill a sense of pride and promote unity among us. Instill, to put, to imbibe, to insert. What? National integrity into every person. It quickly captivated India, gaining the maintaining near anthem status ever since. National anthem, even if it is sung, people with reverence they stand. Right? In the same manner, whenever Milesurat Mera Tumara, if this comes in the television, people use it to stop and look at it. Why? Their people of their recognition are there. People of their recognition are singing. People of their recognition are there playing the musical instruments. And so people, whenever they hear Milesur Mera Tumara, this is the tone over there. And people used to stand there and gluing their eyes to the TV. That is the Sur Mera Tumara. The song's lyrics are unique. One phrase repeated in 14 Indian languages. This Milesur Mera Tumara, this phrase has been repeated in 14 languages. And for you, I'll read the Naswaramo Niswaramo Sangamai Manaswaranga Avatarinche Telugu. And one more, Majatuncha Julta Tara Madhur Tarancha Varasti Dhara Marathi. And if you see, go on seeing many languages you can find out here. And Nannadaniga Ninnadani Dvaniga. Here it is Kannada. And Tumo Amaro Saburoro Milono Srushti Koruachi Eko Tano Odia. Likewise in many languages, 14 languages. And there, if you are a person knowing some language scripts here, you will feel as if you are hearing your own language and you feel elated. That is the spirit of this song. And if you are a Telugu man, if you are in abroad, and if somebody somewhere the Ghantasala songs are being played, automatically you are attached to it, attracted to it, you will go there and you will ask Telugu Rasar Miru. No doubt. And if you hear the Muhammad Rafi over there, or your Kishore Kumar over there, or Mukesh, then simply you will go, are you from India? From which part? Yeah, is it? I had been there for quite long time, I was there. You speak this to him. What is the thread over there? The song. The song could able to make you meet together in a foreign land. You are attached to each other. Then you will try. Do you have that song of Mukesh? Yeah, yeah, I have it. Ah, I have the collection of Mukesh, but this song somehow, if you give, I will copy and give it to you. See how the friendship increases, unity comes from diversity. Through a song it comes. And not only that, Chakde India, that song. Whenever the picture comes and the song comes, the children, they attach it to the field. That is the mesmerizing effect of this song. And so it has been felt that we should have this kind of a song, this kind of inspiration, where we can just instill nationality, its integrity to the people through song. That has been felt, and so it has been written over there, and it has been sung on many people's lips. The song was being sung whenever it has come. Many people, even if it is a Tamil, I'm very certain he must have sung those two lines. And if it is Odia fellow, he must have. Karnataka, he must have. Telugu, he must have. Punjabi, he must have done that. Right? So the feeling, what is the feeling? It is mine. It is mine, that feeling, how it comes. When the food is your own, this one. Right? Baigan ka bharta, yadi bola gaya to people of Bihar, they come out. Yes, it is our own food. Right? And if it is some fish curry, etc., fadak, the Bengali people will say, yes, Rasogulla, it is mine. They claim Rasogulla is mine. That kind of claiming capacity or claiming character should be there. And so the songs are the same meaning and the same, what we can say, the instilling capacity, but different sounds, different languages. If it is there, people feel, yes, it is mine. To show Kerala, the elephants have been shown in the water. And to show Andhra, something else has been shown. Right, to show Karnataka, some other thing has been shown. Kerala, the dances have come. This means all the wonders, all the cultures have been shown in that. So the song, which can live for long and long and long years, that should be the inspirational. When it comes to inspirational, Rabindranath Tagore, he writes, or he must not have thought that I am inspiring some people through my poetry, where the mind is without fear. If you go through that, if you read that, really you feel, yes, this should have been our country. This should have been the anthem of our country. That way you feel, where the mind is without fear. Right? I will read that for you. Here. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into fragments of narrow domestic walls. Domestic, narrow domestic walls. You are Odisha and I am Andhra, I am Telugu, I am Telangana, and I am Tamilian, I am Karnataka. This way, if at all you are thinking that you are building your own walls in between and you are separating yourself from others, don't build them, don't have the walls, then you are one. If you don't have that feeling, you are one, you are an Indian, you are a human being. That kind of freedom Rabindranath Tagore has seen during that period, very, 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 very early to your independence. People were fighting for freedom. I can say those people who fought for it, who died for it, for freedom, they might not be knowing the meaning of freedom. And so here Rabindranath Tagore wanted to put, what is a freedom? Where the knowledge is free. Where the knowledge is free. Why? He had written that. During Sipahi mutiny, the information could not flow freely from one to one. Then it endangered the cause itself of Sipahi mutiny. So the information should pass on. It should not be stopped somewhere. It should have a free flow. It should not lose its way in the dreary desert sands. It should not lose. The faith should be there, the truth should be there. People can put their heads high. Why I can put like this? Yes, I am an Indian. When you say that, this head is held very high. I am a part of free India. Yes, your head has been kept high. And I am a knowledgeable person. I know the knowledge. I have the knowledge. I have the information. You see, people are speaking. Fluently they speak. Why? They have the knowledge. And so they can put it, they can talk over. People hear it. Certain people talk. We feel bored and we go away from that. Why? He doesn't have information. He is not giving information. Something blah blah is speaking. Your talk should be meaningful. Your talk should be informative. Then people will hear. And there should be a meaning for your freedom even. That is what Rabindranath Tagore said during that period itself. Pre-independent days he has put over there. And now with pride we can say, yes, our thought process is very pure and it does not dry itself in the dead habits. Dreary sands, no, it won't go. We do not have dead habits. Right? Our thought process is a free flow. That way you can keep your head high. Right? That is what is wanted. Unity, integrity, freedom, and a oneness in the community. That is what we are taught in this Unit 6. So, now we are Indians because of our culture, because of our tourism, because of our traditions, our traveling, right? And because of our cleanliness, hygiene and eco-friendly things, right? And even we have the space knowledge, right? Political knowledge we have, economical knowledge we have, everything we have. So we are the Indians. We have to feel proud for that. With that, this book comes to an end.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.